Breaking news out of the UK, Apple has pulled its end-to-end encryption for iCloud, removing it altogether. We're going to talk about, is this a backdoor? Should you be concerned? If you're in the UK, what do you do? And especially if you're outside the UK, should you be concerned? What's in it for you? Let's break this all down. There's a lot to unpack, but I'm going to go through it as quickly as I can. Make sure to stick around to the end so you have the full scoop. Real quick, if you've never heard of it, regular iCloud has some end-to-end encryption for things like Apple Health, iMessage, and your passwords via keychain. Apple released something called Advanced Data Protection, which pretty much releases end-to-end encryption for most of the rest of the Apple suite, with the exception of three things, which are mail, calendar, and contacts. Those are legacy technologies that don't really support end-to-end encryption very easily, but everything else in the suite had end-to-end encryption, which is a huge improvement and gave a very great base layer of privacy and security, and still is in most parts of the world, just no longer in the UK. Now, not too long ago, the UK asked for the right to see certain data that not even Apple could access. This is in reference to ADP, because with ADP, Apple can't access your data. They can access some metadata, but they can't access the data itself. Now, specifically, what the UK actually wanted was a backdoor. They asked for a backdoor. They said, you can keep the feature, but we want access to the data, which is essentially asking for a backdoor. So Apple had a few choices. Their first choice was to comply directly with what the UK government wanted and build a backdoor and not alert their users, which was an option. The second option was to just pull out the feature altogether. And the third option is to pull out the whole company from the UK. They've kind of gone with this middle option, which is a bit polarizing because some people think they should have done more and just threatened to pull out of the UK. Some people think that they shouldn't have done anything and just kept ADP, which would be illegal and has other repercussions. So what they are doing is pretty much pulling the whole feature out of the UK specifically. So those of you in the UK, if you go into your settings and you've never enabled this, you're going to see that Apple can no longer offer advanced data protection in the UK to new users. This has already happened. Now, if you're somebody who has been watching this channel and has used ADP because you were a smart person who wanted to enable end-to-end encryption so Apple couldn't see your data directly, you still have ADP enabled. They can't remotely disable it. Now, we don't know what this is quite going to look like yet, but existing users' access will be disabled at a later date. If you're using ADP, in the long run, that will no longer be an option to you. So most likely, they're going to force users to disable the feature in order to still have access to their iCloud account. We'll talk about what to do if that is you. Before covering the good, bad, and what to do, I just want to make a quick note that what the UK is doing is essentially asking for weaker security for everybody. Every cybersecurity expert out there disagrees on a lot of things, but one thing they agree on is that you can't build a backdoor just for the good guys. What the UK is asking to do sets a super dangerous precedent because they are trying to weaken the security of everybody out there. There is no way to build a backdoor that only the UK can access. This would allow hackers, third-party governments, and anybody else to access sensitive information as well. And I do think that Apple at least made a semi-right move by not complying with the backdoor order, as they know this would be disastrous for their users as well. So there's good and bad news out of this story. The good is that the UK demanding a backdoor in ADP demonstrates the UK can't get access to this information. A lot of people, this is not evidence-based, but a lot of people say, there's no way it's end-to-end encrypted, even though you have your own encryption key and you store it yourself and it's set up like every other end-to-end encrypted service. This is proof that governments can't just access the data, otherwise they wouldn't be pressuring a backdoor and this situation simply wouldn't exist in the first place. So if you're using ADP, have some confidence that what you're doing is end-to-end encrypted, and we'll talk about this soon. The second good is that Apple did not fully comply with this. Instead of building a backdoor in a sneaky way and hiding it behind some crazy thing your users didn't know about, they just yanked the feature altogether. This is a partial win. Again, I think Apple could have fought harder, and I'll talk about this soon, but it's a win that we didn't see a secret backdoor. Now the bad. I think the first thing is that this demonstrates how fickle end-to-end encrypted tools are in general and why resilience is so important. All it took was a country to pretty much just say, Apple, you can't do this, and Apple goes, Yeah, you're right. We can't do that. And this is why I'm a huge proponent for allowing sideloading, allowing third-party integrations, making iOS a more open platform. Because if iCloud's end-to-end encryption isn't allowed on iOS, you now have to rely on these crappy third-party integrations that don't really work well with things like the Finder, with things like your messages. There are no like full system backups that are possible on iOS unless you're using iCloud. So these are just a few examples of areas where if Apple just opened up their ecosystem a little bit more, it would make the whole ecosystem more resilient to things like this. And it's similar to how Apple pretty much allows any government to shut down any app because they only allow you to install apps from a singular app store that they have control over. So when China says, ban this app, Apple, they say, sure. And then people can't download WhatsApp or Telegram or Signal or any other end-to-end encrypted messengers on the App Store or anywhere for that matter, because it's the only place to get apps on an iPhone. I want to really outline here that every other operating system does not have this limitation. So Apple choosing to keep iOS a lockdown platform is awful for resilience, and we're seeing why in another example. The second bad thing here is that this sets a dangerous precedent. Other countries will likely now attempt similar moves to try to get Apple and other companies to comply in a similar fashion or just pull out the features altogether. At the end of the day, the government's still getting what it wants, which is easier access to users' data. A lot of people are already saying, well, that's why I use this other end-to-end encrypted cloud provider. People, the precedent this sets is that any end-to-end encrypted cloud provider could be a victim of this type of thing. Apple's the first one because they're the largest, and this is an easy feature to target, and Apple is an easy person to go after. But if you're using another end-to-end encrypted cloud provider and your government doesn't want you using it, there is a lot they can do to try to prevent you from using that cloud provider. So this sets a very dangerous precedent that impacts a lot more than just Apple users. So now I want to talk about what to do if you're a UK user or if you're not a UK user. We're going to start with UK users who currently have advanced data protection enabled. You and your data are still safe. This is not being disabled overnight. You still have end-to-end encryption, but you need to act quickly. So go to techlore.tech/resources or go to alternative2.net. This is our site, it's open source, and you can go ahead and start going through some secure private alternatives. On the cloud side of things, there's Proton Drive. You could always self-host Nextcloud. There's Mega. You can do things like Cryptomator and still keep iCloud. So you do the encryption yourself before it touches iCloud. And you can also just keep things on your local network with Sync Thing. And we have tons of other alternatives out there that you can check out. I really can't stress this enough. If you are currently using ADP and you are in the UK, you will be forced to disable it at a certain point in time. So what you need to do is start migrating your data right away to another end-to-end encrypted cloud provider and then deleting your data from iCloud, because eventually they're going to require you to disable ADP and move that data back to regular iCloud where Apple can once again see the data. So start moving quickly on that. We don't know the timeline for this yet. If you're a UK user who never had ADP enabled, then I still recommend going to our resources or alternative2.net and finding these and start moving to them. It's just a good, healthy reminder that Apple can see a lot of your data if you don't have ADP enabled. Now, if you're outside the UK, rest assured that ADP is still safe and probably isn't going anywhere. I have no reason to think that Apple's going to pull this feature in other places for a while. Now, that can change, and this does set a precedent, and other countries are going to go, wow, that worked, and this could make our lives a little bit easier, so maybe we'll do that too. So I use ADP as well, and what I'm going to be doing and what I recommend to other users out there is to have backups ready to go. I already have backups ready to go. I have things I self-host. I use things on the side like Ente and different end-to-end encrypted note providers. So I already have them ready to go and I can just easily pivot some things over. I really just can't stress enough that if you keep using ADP, you don't need to move off of it right away, but you need to have backups ready to go. Or at minimum, just make a plan of what you choose to move to or do data exports so your data is ready to upload. Just try to have yourself be a little bit more prepared than if this is just yanked out from under you like the UK users. Now, I've seen some questions or comments on social media that I'll quickly try to give my thoughts on. One, I'm getting a question, should I still use ADP? Assuming obviously you're outside of the UK. I think if you're in the Apple ecosystem, I still think ADP brings a lot of value. But I think this is a good reminder that it's not as resilient of a tool as some of the other end-to-end encrypted cloud providers. With that said, I do question, you know, Proton went forward and said, we wouldn't comply with this. But if you push a little bit harder and you ask, well, what would you do in this situation? They say, oh, we don't really know. So I think it's easy to say, yeah, we don't comply with this. But if most companies were in Apple's situation, they would probably do something similar. So I think it's just important to realize the resilience of the tools that you use and understand that ADP and other end-to-end encrypted tools can be banned or can be blocked, or you can be prevented from using them. So always keep backups, always have alternative services ready to go, because you never know what's going to happen to the main ones. And I think that ADP, as of right now, is not really in direct threat in other countries, because what the UK has done is they passed a law that made it easier for them to do this, and now they're finally doing this. That law hasn't even necessarily been passed in many other countries around the world yet, so we'll probably get at least another warning before this happens elsewhere. My opinion on just what I've seen. Now, some people have already asked about trying to bypass this. And for this, we can look to the DMA, the Digital Markets Act in Europe, where Apple is forced to allow sideloading and third-party web engines and default browsers that are different from Safari. This is only allowed in Europe, and Apple doesn't want people outside of Europe to have those perks. So Apple had to have some kind of geographic restrictions in place, and that's what they're probably going to be doing in the UK. This is just my speculation, but I am fairly confident that's what's going to happen. Now, some people think, I just use a VPN. It's not that simple. They use things like your iCloud's billing address. They also use like your credit card billing address. They can also see the country that you're in depending on your GPS and location services, and also things like your cell tower that you connect to. So if you're able to spoof a lot of things to make it seem like you're in another country, then by all means, give it a shot and see if you're able to spoof things. But it's never a guarantee. And if the EU DMA is any indicator, this isn't going to be an easy thing to bypass for most users, so not an easy thing to do. Another question I've seen is, is there any end-to-end encryption at all? Based on my understanding and what's shared, you're pretty much reverting back to just regular iCloud end-to-end encryption, which means things like iMessage, your Apple Health, and your end-to-end keychain and your passwords will be end-to-end encrypted, as well as a couple other more sensitive things. So this is not removing all end-to-end encryption in the entire iCloud suite. It's just removing a majority of it for people who have ADP. But rest assured, there is at least some basic end-to-end encryption with, again, a lot of asterisks, because the reason why ADP was released in the first place is because things like iMessage being end-to-end encrypted didn't really matter when people performed a backup on their phone, which sent those messages to an unencrypted backup that Apple could read anyway. And governments were requesting those and getting access to users' messages indirectly, even though they were end-to-end encrypted. So this issue is now reopened in the UK. I've also just seen a lot of comments saying, oh, this is why I use this operating system, or this is why I don't use Apple. And I think a lot of those people are really missing the point that they are not, this is not really inherently or directly an OS issue. This is an end-to-end encrypted cloud issue. So anything that's end-to-end encrypted, Proton, TUDA, any of these services theoretically could have a similar issue happen to them. This has nothing to do with an operating system. The one thing Apple can do that is OS related is opening up their OS a bit more so that other cloud providers can offer similar end-to-end encryption on their platform so that there isn't a central point that can be targeted that prevents people from having end-to-end encryption on their device. But any other provider that has end-to-end encryption can theoretically be attacked in the same way, and nobody is safe. And if you're arguing about operating systems, you're missing the whole point. Takeaways: if you're in the UK, you better be contacting your politicians about this, calling, texting, emailing, letters, whatever it takes. If you know people around you, be sure to educate them. People don't understand this stuff. And if you break it down in a simple way of like, yeah, they are literally going after basic math, basic encryption in the UK, all for what? If you're outside the UK, you also need to contact your politicians, because we see these kind of end-to-end encryption attacks all over the world. The UK has definitely been one of the worst, but places like Australia, the US, China, Russia, et cetera, have all tried to attack them in some way, shape, or form at different points of time. Get active, use encryption, normalize encryption, and now that can make a big difference. Thank you all for watching. I want to thank our sponsor, NotSnook, for continuing to sponsor our content, which is an end-to-end encrypted notes provider. And I also want to thank all of our patrons. You are all wonderful and make this content possible, and we couldn't do it without you. Join them down below at patreon.com/techlore. And I also made a budget privacy video. I realize I'm small. Wait, I can make myself big. Ooh. Boom! Check out our budget privacy video right here, and I'll see you next time on TechLore.